Welcome back after lunch. We will continue with using Linux tools. So unless there are questions from Kolhapur, we will. Are there any questions from Kolhapur? Please ask your question.
So my question is regarding the relative pathing. When we give the absolute address, at that time we get the direct the directory wherever we want to go. But when we are giving the relative address, at that time how we want to shift, because the same name can be there for the directories within the directories.
Of course. Yeah. Very good question. Yeah. So let me repeat the question. So we have some path for each file. We have many directories. Many subdirectories might have the same file. So how do we locate? How do we give the exact path? Absolute path, not just relative path, but absolute path. That is a question that we received from Kolhapur Institute of Technology, Kolhapur. This is indeed a very important question. So whatever PWD gives is the present working directory. It gives the absolute path. Yeah. So please come back to this. Yeah. So we are here. Yeah. So what all is here? There's nothing. Let's go back. Yeah. So .. When we say the .. denotes the parent directory, and that is relative. Compared to where we are now, that is the current directory. It is one path back. Yeah, let us, for example, go back to dir3. Yeah, so cd ... is also the same as cd.:// Yeah, so this is, .. means what? It's a parent of .. Everything starts from current. Yeah, at some situations it is obvious that current is there. You don't have to write it explicitly. But now let us see. Look at all the uncles. So these are all the siblings of our parent. So we have pressed tab there, and it is showing these are the completions. We could go inside dir2, and then again press tab. What is it that I am doing? I am pressing tab. There is nothing inside dir2. So let us go one more. So this is all relative. The fact that you are using .. means, yeah, let us go back. This is current. Of the current we have gone to one parent. Of the parent we have gone to another parent. And now let us do tab. Yeah, now there is dir1 and test files. Of course, dir1 is expected. By doing 2 dots, we are looking at inside desktop directory. What all is there further? dir1 has to be there. Yeah, what else is there? Test files is there. That is what is coming when we press tab 2 times. Why don't we go inside test files? Yeah, so this way of navigation is what can be called relative. This is a question, if I understand right, this is a question. This is a location of various files, directories. This is all relative. What about absolute? This is absolute. Yeah? PWD will always give. If you specify the directory structure starting from slash, means slash is the root. Starting from slash means it's absolute path. Yeah, there is no .. etc. specified here. We can go to another /cd/home/belur/desktop. Yeah, we can use tab here also. Now we are specifying absolute path. Now we can press tab. This test files, okay, again press tab. So this, by saying cd is a command. After that you have to specify where to go. Now you are specifying the destination. That destination can be specified absolute path. Absolute path always has to start with slash. Yeah, so this, now we are specifying absolute path. Each time I am pressing tab. Now there are multiple ways of completion, so we will go to one. These are the various directories we already went in the morning. Yeah, I am just showing that we can go by absolute path also. This is how we can cd. Yeah, now we are here. This is indeed the destination we had given. If you had given relative way of going to that destination, still PWD will give us the absolute path. So this address, what the word that was used was address. So we prefer using the word path. the destination you can specify as absolute path or relative path. Let us see what all files are here. These are the various files we created in the morning, first things in the morning. These are the various directories we created. Now, what ls of course does not necessarily need a command. What about cd? What if we give cd new? We will go to the new directory, but just cd if we give and we do not give anything, what happened? It did not give an error. To which directory did it change to then? Yeah, you typed cd, name of the command, and you did not type any destination. So, where did it go? How will we check that? By typing pwd. PWD is like always, it is like our GPS, it will always tell us where we are now, present working directory. It will always give us absolute location. Yeah, by GPS it will give us latitude and longitude, think of it like that. Yeah, it will not tell us your with respect to your home, you are 5 kilometers to the right or left, north, east, not like that. Yeah. So notice that when you just type cd, you have come to /home/Belur. Yeah. It indeed changed the directory. What was the earlier directory? We had gone inside this particular, inside another test we had gone after going to this. After going here, we went inside another test, and then when we typed cd, we came to this. So, this is called home. Yeah. Wherever you are, from wherever you are, you type cd, then you have come to home. So, this is one shell variable. Each person, I mean, Belur may not be a directory in your computer, it will not take you to Belur directory in yours. In my particular computer, login name is Belur, yeah, that is my name, my surname. That is why the home directory of this terminal is /home/Belur. That particular information is stored inside home variable. So, the home is a shell variable, so called shell variable. Shell variables we will see in much detail certainly tomorrow, but right now let us see echo space dollar home. Yeah, this information is always there with the shell. No matter which directory you have gone, when you type just cd, then you will go back to home. Yeah, this information is always contained. Yeah, just like I told you before, old pwd we had used, right? This is another shell variable. That information is there. From home Belur desktop, we had done cd, we had changed directory and come to home. Yeah, you also present working directory is also perhaps there. Yeah, if you go to cd desktop test files. Yeah, so now so if you want to go to the previous command on your terminal, please use up arrow mark key. Yeah, when you use up arrow mark key, you can slowly navigate through all the commands that we had typed in that sequence. How to search through a particular command instead of searching through all of them, that also we will see. So, echo home variable still has, it is something you should not touch ideally. All the capital letter variables is something we should not try to manipulate. Yeah, or if you want to introduce your own shell variable, use small variables. It is just like when we are doing some mathematical calculation, we say let x be equal to 5. Yeah, we do not mind using different variables for numbers 5, 6, sin x, let f of x be equal to sin of x. Yeah, but do we say let pi be equal to 3? No, pi is an extremely important variable which always has this particular number 3.14 something, some long number. Yeah, so like that, these capital letter variables, capital letter shell variables are something we should not be touching. Yeah, I mean, unless somebody is really a big bash shell programmer, one should ideally not touch this. Okay, so what other shell variables are there? We are still dealing with that question. This is our present working directory. Whatever came out as output is also actually there inside a shell variable. What about, yeah, we had gone from our home directory, we had come to this directory. So, that is also information in some shell variable. So, yeah, does this answer the question about relative paths, etcetera? Okay, so there was a question from Don Bosco College, Guwahati, which we had not taken up just before we broke for lunch. So, we will take that now. So, please ask your question now.
Sir, I tried to give a file from the terminal. I did not give any name to the file, but I gave the extension as .doc. So simply dot dot, I use vi dot dot, and if I have not so many desktop, but when I use the terminal with the command ls minus al, I can see the file.
Yeah, the question, yeah, we understood the question. Let me just repeat the question. If I understand right, you are saying that you created a new file using a VI editor. Of course, we are very happy about you using the VI editor, but that's a personal choice. So what you said is you created a file with a file name starting with dot. Yeah, let's say dot doc or dot txt, and when you see it using Windows browser, using a file browser in Ubuntu, then it is not visible. But then if you go to the terminal and do ls, again expectedly it is not visible, but you do ls minus a and then it is visible. Yeah, of course, to a large extent you have already answered the question. The reason is that you said nothing dot dot txt. Yeah, if the file name starts with dot, it will not be visible for various programs. Yeah, even in the folder, how to make it visible, this is something I do not know. At least I am used to the command prompt more, and in the command prompt, if you want to see the dot files, ls minus a is the one to use, and we would encourage you to do that. How to create the file instead of touch, this particular person has used the VI editor. We will spend some time on various editors, on various simpler editors. And VI is indeed an extremely good editor that some of us here use, but in this course you are encouraged to use any editor. If you ask me my preference, I use VI, Vim editor. Okay, any other question? Okay, so we will proceed to the next topic, which is about MVCP and these commands with or without the I option. Let us go to, we have a few directories here. So let us make a file called file 1. Now let us copy this file 1 to file 2. Yeah. So copy is a command, source destination. Yeah. So copy, when you are copying, you are supposed to say from what to what. Now you have to give two arguments. If you do not give two, then what it will do? Of course, good to give this a question, good to ask this question, try to answer it, we will see it now. Yeah. So if you type like this, then it will create a new file. Yeah. So first file 1 got created using touch command, file 2 got created, file 1 was copied to file 2. Yeah. What if we try to copy it again? File 2 already exists. The destination, yeah, we are trying to copy file 1 now, and we are trying to give a destination that is already a file, already existing file. Yeah, of course, right now these are all empty files because I use touch command, there nothing very important there, but more generally you might be working on different versions and you have spent a lot of effort, all the information is there, and you do not want to copy another file as this file and lose the old file and overwrite the old file. Now this is potentially a big problem. At least my settings again tells that it is asking me, do you want to overwrite file 2? Yeah. On your computers, you are encouraged to check that it will in general not ask. The default setting is it will not ask, it will just go ahead and overwrite again cruelly. Yeah. So in my case, it is saying, it is asking me, if I just press enter, it means it will not overwrite. Yeah. Say yes. Sorry. Now if I say yes, then it will overwrite. Yeah. So otherwise, again as expected, CP minus I is the one that will really ask us. It is in interactive mode. If you want to overwrite without being asked, F means force. If you want to force the overwrite, CP minus F, for those of you who might by default have the minus I option, yeah, you might want to alias it to the minus I option. If you do not want to be asked for a very specific case where plenty of files you are overwriting and you do not want to be asked again, then minus F option will just go ahead, array, because it is already having that alias, it is still asking. Minus F option does not overwrite the interactive option for CP command. It turns out, as I come to know now. Okay, what about move? Move means move file 1, file 3. Yeah. So file 1 was already there. File 1 has got renamed. Move is as good as rename. Yeah, move in fact is more, is better than that, because you can move these files across directories, across different long paths. Yeah, rename may or may not work. Move can also move directories from one directory to another place. Yeah, CP also can copy entire directories, including subdirectories. Are the additional options that one can give. But let's come back to this overwrite possibility. Yeah, so now there are these files. We just listed what all files are there. There are file 2, file 3. Now what if we try to move file 2 to file 3? Yeah, we are trying to move a file to a destination that's already there. Again, we have, there is this potential concern that file 3 will be lost. Yeah, at least my computer now asks me, the default it is in interactive mode. It's asking me, do I really want to overwrite? If I just press enter, enter means no. It's the safer side. It's conservative. Since that person has not entered anything, let us not overwrite. Yeah, it's like that. I say both the files are there. Suppose we again say yes. Now indeed file 2 is not there. File 2 has got overwritten to file 3. These are the different parts about move. So you can also move across directories, subdirectories. If you don't want the file name to be different, when you move, let us see what is there inside another. Yeah, there's nothing inside this. See, there is something in examples. Yeah, inside examples there are plenty of files. You can try to make an example directory and make some files just for some test files. The fastest way to create some files with a specified file name is using the touch command. So in my examples directory, here is various directory. I am in this particular path. What is there in examples? These are the various ones. Suppose I want to copy items.txt. So you all are encouraged to use the tab command for quicker completion. It will complete whenever there is no ambiguity. Suppose I want to copy the items.txt to the same file here. What one thing I can do is item.txt, I can type it here. Yeah, cp is the command, of course. This is the source. That source is not in the current directory, but it is inside the examples directory incidentally. And from that examples directory, this items.txt file copied here. In this current directory, what file name should it be? Suppose we don't want to change the file name. Yeah, we are free to choose any file name. Yeah, some new item. Nobody stops us from choosing a new file name. New items.txt, we can go ahead and copy. Yeah, so new items.txt has got copied from within the examples directory to the current directory. But then very rarely you want to change the file name. If from different directory to this directory, there may not be a requirement to change the file name. If you want to give the same file name, one option is to actually type items.txt. Other option is to say that the default, why change? One way to do, can you go ahead and not specify anything? Let's see. If you don't give any destination, it'll say look, missing destination file operand after examples. Yeah, you have to give a destination. Now what is a good way where you don't want to specify the name of the file because the file name is the same, but still destination has to be provided. So that is where dot plays a key role. Here just say dot. Dot means what? Will it override the current directory? No, file cannot override directory. This much basic intelligence Linux terminals will have. So now it will understand that it should be the same file name in the current directory. Yeah. So if you in the destination, if you give something that is already existing, some directory name that is already existing, then CP command will understand that it should be the same file with same name inside this new directory. And for current directory, we need the dot. So look, now when we do ls, we see that this items.txt indeed has got copied from within examples directory into the current directory. Yeah. Now how do you copy the same? Cp examples items to another. Yeah, inside another there are some more directories inside. By pressing tab once, nothing got completed. By pressing the tab key two times, it showed us all these completions that were possible. Because so many completions were possible, it did not complete itself. It is now showing us those options. Yeah. So one tab key will complete if possible. If not possible, second tab key will then show you those possible completions. Now of them you have to choose one, yeah. So here example, now we are copying items.txt is a file we have to copy. From within examples directory we are going to pick it, and we are going to now finally put it inside this directory. So inside this directory, is directory mein pahuncha denge. That dialogue cannot be reproduced in English, so spare me for this. So inside this directory it will copy it. Why don't we see what's there inside? Yeah, please don't think that I'm typing very fast. Please use the tab key as well as possible. I also have been using this. Now inside another test then directory, inside that particular directory there's only one file name. Yeah, that is why it has in fact completed it. Let us do ls items.txt has got copied there. Yeah, I think this is straightforward. Similarly move also can move a particular file, not just copy but actually move it. When you move it means at the source, that particular file is no longer there in the source place. Similarly you can move entire directories from one place to another. Directory, when you move all its files, all its subdirectories, everything will get moved to the destination. What about copying directories? Copying directories, I mean lot of move, after all no big disk space. Yeah, the same location, that much file, instead of here it is somewhere else. But copy, I think is better to be sure that this person really wants so much of copying from here to there. Yeah, how much of disk space we might have, all our files are larger and larger, and we should be concerned about making big copies of directories. So if you want to copy directories with along with subdirectories all the files, minus r is the option to do it recursively. So this is something you can check yourself. R for recursive, this is an option you have to give only for cp command when you are copying directories from source to destination. Okay, let us come back to this and see what else about moving files, copying files, removing, etc. we have been seeing. When you are copying, as I said, R is the option for recursive. Yeah, I option if you want to be asked interactively whether you really want to remove, overwrite or not. I for interactive, while moving it will be overwrite, while removing it will ask you whether you really want to remove. While copying also the concern is overwrite. Minus I option works the same way for all these three. Okay, so if there are no questions about this, then we can go further into hierarchy, Linux file hierarchy, permissions, ownership. So we already saw that slash is a so called root directory. At this particular place we tried to make a directory earlier this morning and it said permission denied. Yeah, so slash is called the so called root directory. Only the root, in many Linux systems the root is also called the super user, SU for short. Super user has permission. For your computer you only might be the super user, that is very much possible. So it is the topmost level of hierarchy. Yeah, think of it like a tree. The slash is like the bottom of the tree from which one by one all branches are coming out, and different directories, files and all are created. If it is a file then it cannot have a subdirectory, in that sense it is like a leaf. So there is something called HIER, higher. So now about permissions and access control is extremely important, especially in the same particular system different people might be using. They all might have different accounts. Yeah, especially in a laboratory setup many people might have different people sharing computers, sharing accounts in the same computer inside a LAN setup. That is when it is very important, at least for the super user, to be aware what files should be available, accessible to all. For an individual it is required that his files are not visible to others. Perhaps it is required that certain files are visible to others. Yeah, so in a multi-user environment it is very important that one should know exactly how to set the permissions. Yeah, access control is extremely important. Super users have to play certainly be careful about this. So ls minus l is some option we have been using so far. So we already saw the first letter d tells whether it is a directory or a file. Dash means file, d means directory. There are some other letters also that are in general possible. So then after that we are now not worrying about the first letter anymore. Then there are these three letters r, w, x. Yeah, then another 3 letters, another 3 letters. Yeah, so, totally 9 letters after the D character. So, what do these 9 characters mean? So, first 3 mean something, the next 3 mean again the same thing but for a different person, and again the last 3 mean the same thing for third group of. So, this user is, okay, let us see all this in more detail. Okay, as it says, first column shows permission information. This entire thing is about permissions. Yeah, first character itself specifies the file, whether it is a directory or a file. Yeah, directory files have dash, directories have D. So, RWX in short stand for read, write and execute. Yeah, so read is just permission to read, write is permission to write, execute means can you execute it as a command. Secondly, if it is a directory, then the directory has to have execute permission, because you have to be able to go into that directory and type other commands. So, execute permission is very important for directories also, not just for commands, but for directories also. So, read and write, of course, everybody will understand more easily. Yeah. So, the first letter, as well, the first letter is all these letters, if the permission is there, it will say R, read permission is there. If the permission is not there, there will be a dash. Yeah. So, let us go back here, there is this dash here, there is a dash here, but there is W here. The middle character is write for only the first 3, but for the next 2 sets of 3 characters, it is not there. So, for whom is write there, for whom is write not there, that is what we will see now. So, the permissions can be changed not by anybody, but by only by the owner of the file. Who is the owner now, where is that information? Yeah, is root, is the super user the owner of all the files? So, that is what we will see now. So, let us go back to this. So, when we do adjust ls, we see all these files, ls minus l will tell us, why do not we just see ls minus l of just one file, file 3. Yeah. So, for this particular file, this first particular name is user, yeah, it is me. The second one is incidentally again Belur, I should say that is only incidental. More generally, it is a group of people. Yeah, what is group about it? For example, in our department server, there are groups, faculty members, postgraduate students, undergraduate students, these are all different groups. Why these different groups are important? Because you see, students you might want to categorize into 2009 batch, 2010 batch. Yeah, after let us say 3-4 years, you can remove that entire group, all files in one go. We do not have to be worried about who has passed out, who has not passed out. Yeah, we know that entire batch would have left by then. Yeah, in that sense it is very helpful to form a group, but on my this personal computer, there is, for such personal computers typically the group is the user. Yeah. So, now for the file 3, for the name called file 3, the first letter of course is a dash, means it is not a directory, that is why it is a dash. The next 3 letters are what permissions the user has, user is Belur. The next 3 letters are what permissions others in that group have. Yeah, in this case incidentally the group is Belur, and the last 3 are the permissions that all others who have an account in that computer have to this file. Yeah, so that is what the last 3 letters are. So, what it says is user has, the user Belur has write permission, but nobody else has write permission. Why? Because there is a dash there. Yeah. Does the user himself have execute permission? No, there is a dash there, in place of X there is a dash. Yeah, for this particular file, for files generally there is no execute permission for nobody. If it is a command, if you have carefully written a command that can execute and do something, then you go ahead and give execute permissions to that file. So, how to change the permissions, how to change the mode, so this is called mode. Yeah, all this information is called mode, that information is changed using the chmod command. So, let us go back to this particular file, change mode command is to be used, minus R is for recursive option. So, if you want to change all the, you want to give write permission to plenty of files inside directories, subdirectories all in one go, then minus R is the option. As I said, R is for recursive, either capital R or small r, when there are 2 important words starting with R, then one will be capital, one will be small typically. Yeah. So, how do you change the permission of this particular file? For example, this is how one can do it. This is the first simple way to learn it. change mode, only the user can type this. Others try to type this, it will say you are not the user, you are not the owner of this file. U for user, G for group, plus meaning you want to add permission to this, X, add what permission? Execute permission to this file. Yeah. So, this is an extremely important thing. This is one of the most difficult commands amongst all the commands we have seen so far, move, cp, ls, touch, file, rm. This is the most complicated. U for user, G for group, plus for whether that execute permission has to be given now or denied. Yeah, X for give, and X, what permission are you talking about? Are you planning to give read permission or write permission or execute permission? We are speaking about execute permission. So, X for execute to foo.sh. So, why don't we try these permissions to the particular file we saw? Yeah, so okay, it's a good idea to see this also. U for user, G for group, O for all others, O for others, meaning outside the group. A is for all. In one go, everybody just goes ahead and gets up. It includes the user, plus for adding the specified permission, minus for removing. Equal to means yes, you specify what mode it is supposed to be in. Then you have to finally specify whether this addition or denial of these permissions are for what? Read, write, or execute. Yeah, these are the three information we have to give. So let's go back to this terminal. Let's see in detail the permissions for file 3. Yeah, it says that the user has read and write permission, but the user doesn't have execute permission. Others in the group have read permission. Others in the group don't have write and execute permission. Everybody else who has an account in this computer outside this group possibly have read permission, but they don't have write and execute permission. So why don't we change it? Can we change it? Yeah, because we are the user. How do we know we are the user? Another very important command that is not there in the slides called who am I. Yeah, if somebody has left that computer on and gone off and you come on this computer and see you want to know who is this idiot who has logged in and gone, who has logged in, forgot to log out and gone. Yeah, you want to see the name of the idiot. Unfortunately, until that time you have to say who am I. Yeah, computer will tell you that Belur person has logged in. Yeah, so who am I? Belur. So since the person Belur has logged in here there is Belur, that means that the owner of that file is Belur. Certainly chmod command, when you execute, it will not mind, it will not give an error. Change mode, we want to give, let us say to everybody in the group, let us say to all, we want to give the permission, we want to add the permission write, yeah, of which file? File 3. So, it appears like it has not complained, we have given this particular command, it has executed. Let us see whether the permissions have indeed been given or not. Yeah, so it seems to have given. What about execute permission? Why don't we give execute permission? Yeah, it has gone ahead and given execute permission to all. Read and write were already there. Yeah, it seems like everybody has been given all permissions to this file. Does this dash mean that some particular permission is yet to be given? Huh? Does this dash mean that some permission has not yet been given? Earlier, see, there was this dash here. That dash meant execute permission was not given to the user. But what about this dash? Which permission is yet to be given? Yeah, this dash, person here says, this dash doesn't mean some permission has not been given. That dash anyway is supposed to say whether it is a directory or a file. This dash does not signify lack of some permission. Yeah. So, please note, every dash need not mean lack of some permission. It means it is this first character is supposed to be either directory or not. Yeah, there are some other S letters which are very hard to understand for me, but there are some general other letters also that are possible there, but dash means file, the most common. So, notice that because you have given execute permission, now suddenly your terminal has given some different color rather smartly. Yeah, it thinks that now it is a command to be executed. If it were a directory, different color, file, non-executable file one color black, and executable file another permission. Yeah, so this completes about changing the mode. You can see help chmod, there are better shortcuts using some numbers, using binary descriptions by which we can specify without all this u, g, w, x, plus, minus, without all that, there is a faster way to directly specify the mode of a file using some numbers between 0 to 7. What about chown? If you are not the owner, what to do then? Yeah. So this particular command is relevant for super users generally, for roots. Yeah, if you copy a file forcibly into somebody's directory, you want that person to go ahead and modify and change permissions, change mode. So the person should be the owner eventually. Then whoever is the owner should go ahead and make this other new person the owner. That is when ch own is important. In my opinion, it is not relevant for this particular course, nor is it relevant for today or tomorrow in any case. So ch own changes the owner and the group. You can change both owner and group. The change group can also be done by some other command, ch group, I think, but this is not relevant for this course. So by default, the user, whoever is logged in, whoever creates a file, is the owner. You can change, yeah, you can change the owner by this particular way. The root can certainly change the owner. Okay, so let us just now start opening all these empty files we have created. Let's open the PDF files we have created. Before we go to this important topic, can just take up some questions. So are there any questions so far about file hierarchy, basic file handling, all the topics we have covered so far? How to create users and groups is a question that somebody has asked. So that is very relevant for a super user. Yeah. So since somebody has asked this, we can spend a few minutes on that question. Any other question? If there are no other questions, we will spend time on how to create users and group. Are there any other questions? This is a good time to ask. Yeah, we are connected to Srinagar. Please ask your question.
So my question is, normally if we execute a copy command, it will create a new file with new timestamp. So is there an option in copy?
Yeah.
It's the same question.
Yeah.
Is there an option in copy command so that we actually preserve the old timestamp?
Yeah, yeah.
The file.
Yeah, this is an extremely useful, very important question. So if you, so his question is, when we copy a old file, suppose there is some file 1 month ago you modified it, now you want to copy it at another place, and you want to, he has already noted, he has already checked and noticed that when you copy a 1 month old file now, then suddenly it becomes as if you created it now, as if you modified it now. Yeah, and these timestamps are important. Yeah, for example, we write some code, then we detect some change, somebody discussed, then we want to know whether this is a code after discussion or before discussion. Maybe we are not following good version control practices, perhaps because we all have not done this course already. At the end of this course, maybe you will not have this problem because you will be following good version control practices. So how do you copy? By retaining the timestamp of the source file. This is the question he has asked, which I am sure is possible, just that I do not know now, but Harish here has been smiling saying it is possible. So maybe I can ask him to come and quickly answer this doubt. Yeah. So somebody in Srinagar has asked, somebody else has asked, what was the question in Srinagar center? So question I will repeat again. The question is, how do you copy by keeping the timestamp of the source file?
CP has an option called preserve attributes. Basically, if you use that, it not only preserves the modification time, it preserves the owner, the original owner that the file had, and the timestamp data. All those metadata are essentially as is, unchanged, and copied to the destination folder. CP-P. It's very useful for, you know, doing backups, copying, make projects and all that.
That answers the question about how to copy by keeping the attributes, by preserving the attributes. So P for preserve. We will go to Rajlakshmi Engineering College. So please ask your question now.
My question is in the command apropos, can we use two keywords to find a appropriate command?
So the question from Periyar Institute was that in the command apropos, can we give two keywords? Can we give two keywords and get everything together? So that question is useful. Let me just quickly check. I also don't know. We did apropos remove and timestamp. So whether these two words both have to be there or at least one of them has to be there is the concern. So it has given, if either this or that is there, then it has given those. Yeah, this is a union of the two things. If you had apropos remove, then some commands would have come out. If you had done apropos timestamp, then these other would have come out. These others have clearly nothing to do with remove, but it is giving both now. Yeah, so OR operation seems to have taken place between the two words. Yeah, I believe that answers the question apropos. There was another question about on chat about what are some numbers that come in by what is. Yeah, those numbers, what they mean would be there inside man what is. Yeah, that is why we prefer not taking up that question. We will meanwhile go to another question from Rajlakshmi Engineering College.
Can you give the example of the equal operator, CH mode, sir? Change mode.
So we heard your question. The question was that in CH mode, there is a plus minus that we said. Plus is for adding some permission, minus is for denying some permission. It appeared like equal to is for setting the permission directly, whether or not that permission was there. Perhaps that is what it means, but then I have not checked this, and I strongly encourage all of you to check this and discuss this on Moodle, because this particular fact is not urgent as far as today's and tomorrow's is concerned. I will also check meanwhile. Yeah. So on chat, there is a particular question about how touch command can be used to create an empty file, but cat command can also be used to create a new file with some more meaningful content. Yeah, that's indeed correct, and we will see this in more detail. Somebody else has said, what is the difference between chmod 777 and giving all the permissions? Yeah, so this is indeed correct. There is no difference. So chmod 777, by using these three numbers, everything that is possible by plus minus u g o a x. So please use small x. Yeah, I see that you have given use capital X. Capital X may or may not work, I do not know, but small x is the recommended way. So if you use this in three numbers, that is also fine. They are the same, they are equally helpful. We will go to the next topic about looking at files. So somebody had already asked cat. Yeah, cat is indeed a good way to check what is there inside a file. So what does this say? Cat, cat for displaying the contents of a file. Cat file 1 will display all the information onto the screen by default. Yeah, if you put multiple things, it will also show all the content one after another in this sequence. First it will show this on the screen, then it will show this on the screen. In that sense, it can be very helpful for concatenating various files. Yeah, you show them one after another and just take all the output into one. That is, the cat is for concatenate. Actually it can also be used for seeing a file. So one of the questions is, can we change the default permission given to the directory or file? Yeah, when we create a file, can we change the default permission? So there is some such setting. So I have digressed out of cat command to a question that has been asked on chat. The question is, can we change the default permission given to the directory or files? Yeah, so this is very much possible in Unix or Linux, that every user, you can, whenever you create a file, it will never have read permissions for others. Yeah, that is potentially unsafe to have read permission to others. So this can also be made as a default setting that requires some particular command, I think starting from U. Yeah, somebody knows this? From starting from U, there is some letter, there is some command by which you can make the default permissions to any new file that is created. Yeah, we will check this and let you know on the forum. But this is certainly possible, it is just that I do not remember now. Coming back to cat command. So cat is a command that will spit out all the contents of the file. Umask, somebody else has typed umask. Yeah, this is exactly the command to use if you want to create a new file with specified default permissions. Yeah, thank you very much. MJET34. Mofaka Ja College, Hyderabad, we have an answer. Umask is a command. Yeah, it is many years since I heard of this command. Yeah, okay, thank you very much. So we will go to the cat command. So cat, as I said, is for showing all the contents onto the screen all in one go. everything will come on the screen. Perhaps it is too much per, there might be much more than one screen full. That is when cat is not convenient, that is when less is extremely useful for seeing the contents of a file. What is the significance of less? It will show it on the screen, but one screen full at a time. Yeah, then you can press space bar and see another screen full. You can go on doing this. You can press Q for quitting and coming back to the prompt. So, Q for quit, arrows up down for navigating inside this file which you have opened using using less. You can use NG to directly jump to a particular line. Inside less, very importantly, you can use search for a pattern. Yeah, you can press slash command and then look for a particular pattern. So there's a whole lot of techniques for looking for certain regular expressions, like whether some particular word occurs at the end of the line, whether this particular word occurs at the beginning of the line, whether some pattern occurs at the beginning of a word. Yeah, so that those are all called regular expressions, and this is something very systematically taught in computer science, but we all need to know a little about regular expressions and we will see that in more detail. Yeah, but inside less you can use H for help. So slash pattern is what you can use. So please note, all this is relevant only for plain text files. Yeah, so we are going to spend a lot of time on manipulation of just plain text files, precisely because we have all these tools handy. We have cut, paste, etc. So you will not be able to use less command on a PDF file. If some file is a PDF file and you know some particular word occurs there, less is not the command to use, nor should you use cat. All the content will come on the screen and maybe even the terminal will get spoiled. Terminal meaning the actual monitor hardware will not get spoiled, but you might have to exit that term, exit that shell and start again. In any case, some junk characters is what will come, because PDF files are in general binary files. So we have a question from Amal Jyoti, College, Kerala. We will quickly see that before we continue with less.
Suppose if I am creating a file, how a group is assigned to that file? So like that file may be belonging to a group now.
See, we have understood the question. Yeah, I thought I indeed told that I will discuss about this. So yeah, let us spend some quick time discussing about this. Yeah. So we will disconnect from Amal Jyoti, College, Kerala, because let me repeat the question. The question is, when we create a new file, how is the user group, everybody decided for the file? Yeah. So as I said, this is of primary concern for super users. We as individual Linux users do not have to worry about this. Yeah. On this particular computer, for example, I am a primary user. Sometimes my wife also uses it. She might have different settings, because of which she is also a different user on this. She has separate login account on this. Now, why don't we go and see what files are there in her account? Yeah. So CD. So let's go back here. We have CD. CD means gone to my home. We go CD back. So here are three other users. Totally three users. One is me. One is Fossey. Yeah, Fossey is another login on this. One is Sharbani. Yeah. So let's go to Fossey. So here all these directories are created. We can do ls minus l. Yeah. So here it says Fossey is the user of this directory called desktop. Yeah. What is the group? Fossey. On this computer, when that new user was added called Fossey, that time the separate group was not specified. Yeah. How was the user added? From the command line one can add user. Yeah. Yes. Yeah. So from the command line you can type add user. Yeah, maybe it will ask super user, the add user also works. Yeah, it says only root or group can do it. Only root may add a user or group to the system. So right now I am logged in as Belur, first of all. Then I have gone into somebody else's account, some user called Fossey, and there I am trying to add a user. Yeah, so clearly this add user, group, user, these are all most relevant for the super user. Super user means what? On each computer, if there are multiple users, then it is relevant. So that is the reason that we did not spend too much time on this. it is not relevant for all users. At least today, tomorrow, we want to learn how to use Linux tools as an individual first. Yeah, then the super user, then we all become super users for some computers where multiple people are going to come, and we as a super user should know that different people have different privacies. So, just as an example, let us see now that we will try to remove rm-rf desktop. Yeah, it says cannot remove desktop, permission denied. Why is that? Who am I? Belur. Yeah, Belur is the person logged in. Let us see ls desktop, but ls minus l will show us that desktop is actually this fossee login. Fossee is the owner of this. Only fossee user can go ahead and remove this desktop directory. Yeah, others cannot do this, and quite understandably, at least execute permission has been given to this directory. That is why some other user could come in here and see all this. Yeah, now that person is trying to remove it also, but notice that desktop directory, yeah, has read permission. Read permission, of course, it has read permission for everybody in the fossee group. It also has read permission for all others. I Belur belongs to others. Yeah, so it will allow me to go to desktop. Just read permission is not enough. Execute permission for a directory is also required if one has to be able to go to the directory. Yeah, here one can see, of course, incidentally, there is nothing inside this. Yeah, so this much is all that is relevant. One can go to another person's directory. If you have an account in that computer, you first log in into the computer, then you can navigate backside to the parent directory from your home, and you can see who else is there. You can go to the directory if the execute permission for their directory has been given by them, by that owner. That who created that owner? The super user for that computer. That super user, when creating, would assign some groups. But all this group assignment, user, owner, you mask, all this is relevant only for a super user of a computer where multiple users are logging in. Yeah. So for today and tomorrow, we want to first get used to how to use before we become super user on a computer. Why don't we learn Linux tools for as an individual of our computer? Yeah. That is the reason we don't want to pursue further from here. So let us go back to the slides. We had started seeing the less command. Less command we already saw. You can look for a pattern. We will start seeing this. We'll see some more hands-on of this on the terminal. Meanwhile, there is a question from Amal Jyoti College, Kerala. So yeah, please ask your question. You're connected.
I have one question regarding chmod, that is changing of permission. I want to know what is the syntax for copying one user's, that is one class permission, to another class. To copy the permissions of one class exactly to another class, like user to other.
Yeah, thanks for your question. Her question is, when you copy one file from somewhere to somewhere else, we don't want to know again set from scratch the permissions exactly as it was in the source. Yeah, we will like that the permissions of this new created file are inheriting exactly from the source. That is her question, as far as my understanding is concerned. To the best of my knowledge, the permissions are copied by default. Yeah, or maybe the permissions come from the directory. So let us take an example. Yeah, let's take an example to see this, to see how it is working. So some default permission, how they should come. This information might be there in chmod, help chmod, but let us see an example. Yeah, so we are back to this terminal. We are in this particular directory. It will not help to make a directory here. Yeah, why? Because that particular desktop is in somebody else's login. Yeah, so where are we in this user, fossee user on this computer, but I am not fossee. I am not logged in as fossee. Yeah, I am logged in as Belur. So what to do now? Let's go back. Let us look at the file of examples. Yeah, this is just a file with read permission here. Yeah, sorry. Look at this particular file called examples.desktop. It has these permissions. At least read permissions are given. Why don't I copy examples to Belur examples? Yeah, what is your guess? Will this work or not? when I press enter, will this command execute successfully or not? Yeah. Cannot create regular file, permission denied. Who has denied the permission? Fossee user has denied the permission for others to write a file in the home directory of Fossee. Yeah, permission denied, write permission. Let us ls minus al. Just for a minute, let me make this small. So let me just ls minus al rt. RT are some additional options, so that they're sorted according to the timestamp. Yeah, R for reverse timestamp. The most recent most modified will come at the bottom. Yeah. So you see dot, the current directory where we are in, this has been given no write permission for others in the group, no write permission for others. Hence Belur cannot log in here, cannot navigate and come here and create a file here. Yeah, quite expected. Now why don't we try to copy this particular file, not in the same, yeah, we will copy it one backside, then there are these three we had already seen. This is my own, yeah, here is where I can certainly create successfully. Why don't we copy? We didn't specify the file name, we ended with slash, means same file name. It turns out that there is already one file, it is asking me, yeah, why don't I say just yes. So let us go ahead and see. So there is an examples dot, yeah, and same permission has been given there, yeah, it turns out incidentally the same permission has been given. Is this some default thing or what? Yeah, is this some default? Default, I think the permissions are inherited to the best of my understanding. Yeah, even if sometimes of course I should say permissions are also inherited from the directory. If the directory has been giving read permissions to everybody, then any file you copy there will also be given read permission. This is very relevant for web pages. Yeah, you might copy a file from some other directory into your web directory, whatever files you have kept for others to view on the internet, then automatically they had better have read permission. Unless you explicitly remove the read permission, they will have read permission for others. Yeah, so beyond that we do not want to spend time on chmod. If everybody knows chmod, how to change the mode for a specific file, that is enough. How to set the defaults, you must, luckily somebody has answered that question. Any other question of inheriting etc, we do not need to take in the class. Okay, so we will see a little more hands on of cat and less. So cat items. So when we do cat items.txt, it has shown all of this onto the screen. Yeah, luckily it was only one screen full. Let us see new item. We can also cat two things together, items, new items, both. It has shown one after another both in one go. It has not even bothered to say that this is where the new file is beginning. Yeah, it is just shown all of it in one go. It is very helpful for concatenating. Yeah, you can concatenate plenty of text files one after another. If some file is really big, you can split it into separate files, take it as smaller files. For example, when sending an email, if the file is too big, you can split it, send it as a person to concatenate it using the cat command. So now we can also see less items. Yeah, now it has shown a screen full, but after showing it has not come back to the command prompt. Yeah, it has ended here. It is saying end because there is only one screen full. Yeah. So why do not I create a bigger file? Do not worry about what I am typing now, we will explain what is the meaning of all this greater than sign tomorrow. Why do not we see this bigger? There is a big list, a bigger file, slightly bigger. Actually it is just the double of the previous file. Programming Perls is the first line. Programming Perls is the first line of that items.txt. Programming Perls is again occurring here. Yeah, in fact some same few words, same few characters repeated again. Yeah, but inside this we can look for the word Unix. Yeah, it has shown all of this. We can look for language. Yeah, lang character appears inside language. So it will show all of these and also highlight them. We can do N for next. Yeah, if you want to go to the previous occurrence, capital N will search for. Search is one of the most frequent things we have to do inside a file. Now, on Google, for example, we are all regularly searching various things. Google has to have good algorithms for searching, then searching and replacing. These are the most frequently used commands inside when we are looking through a file. So, how do you do it in less? Press the slash key, immediately your cursor has gone to the bottom, waiting for you to type the pattern. Yeah, you can RAMMMI. It will show all the places where RAMI has occurred. Yeah, RAMI has come in programming. Yeah, in fact, programming is the only place where it has come. And luckily, there are many in the same file, in the same screen full. They are all being highlighted. When you press N, the next one comes to the top of the line. Yeah, the same pattern will come to the top of the screen full that we are seeing. Yeah, we can go to, this is the last pattern being shown. Further, it says pattern not found if you press N again. If you want to go to the previous pattern, capital N is where it is going to the previous pattern, etc. If you want to search, yeah, inside some very big file, let us say of having 1000 lines, if you want to, you might want to search separately front and back, search forward, search backward might be separate. Slash is for searching forward, yeah, question mark is for searching backside. Yeah, in this small file, it does not matter, but for big files, it certainly matters. So, essays, one can ask, is this less case sensitive or not? Yeah, why do not we search for, so it is case sensitive. Yeah, if you want less to be insensitive, then there are some options. You can also, yeah, you can see H and see what are the various options, and surely case sensitive, case insensitive. Insensitive is certainly going to be there. Yeah, so please, we encourage you to use H and help. If you want to always start less, if you want, whenever you use less, if you want it to be case insensitive, yeah, we don't want to be typing capital small separately each time. We don't want to each time set the current less to case insensitive mode. Suppose we don't want to do that each time, it is possible to default set it in insensitive mode. Yeah, these all options are certainly there. And less is one something we strongly encourage you to use much as far as possible for searching various things. Please use less. We also wanted to see cat. Yeah, so cat is relevant when it is just one screen full. Cat bigger has just shown everything on the screen. Importantly, it has come back to the prompt, which was not happening in less. So less of a file was showing it to you and waiting for you to press Q. Why? Because you might want to do various things, you might want to search, etc. So, it is not going to come back to the prompt until you press Q. So, please remember how to quit out of less. Q is the letter to type. Okay, what about word count? So, often in a file, we want to know how many times some particular word occurs. So, word count, WC is the command for statistical information about the file. It will give you three things: number of lines in the file, number of words in the file, and number of characters. Number of characters is extremely important, especially now there are so many websites from which you can send SMS where there is a word count. Yeah, there is some small box, text box, where you have to type the word count, where you type the characters. If you want to predefine the file in your editor and then copy paste it there. So, we want to know in a file how to check the word count. Yeah, so that is what you will use WC for. Before we go to the terminal, let us see what else is there in the next slide. Head, tail, cut. Yeah, so cut of course is the most important thing. Let us see word count, then we will say head and tail. WC bigger, it gives us three integers. This number of lines, number of words, number of total number of characters. Yeah. Computer science people, please do not ask us whether new line character is counted as a character or not. Yeah, it is best to try this oneself. Take one file with empty, many empty lines, many lines on each line, only no character on each line. I can test this whether the number of lines are being counted or not in the character count. You can also, let's see for items. So we please note that this bigger.txt was just was constructed from items.txt by putting it two times one after another. So of course each one of that is double of this. Yeah. So now if you want to, if you think that some important information is only in the last line or only in the first line, yeah. For example, what we had been doing when we are, so head and tail commands are extremely important. Many of our exercises require you to know head, tail well. We will do head and tail in more detail after we stop for tea. Thank you.